Well, Comcast could be your next cable provider. The media company purchased Time Warner Cable in a $45 billion deal today. We spoke with a UT professor who says changes are not going to happen immediately, but still, he says, customers will likely start noticing better service. AT&T and Google will be trying to get Time Warner's customers, and it could also mean changes for your bill.
I think we will in Austin see our prices flatten this year. And then as far as prices go down, I think it's highly likely that when, by the end, another 2 or 3 years, we're going to start to see some price erosion.
Cable companies are also facing competition from video streaming services like Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Hulu. And with the cable industry consolidating, you may be wondering what's going to happen to your cable bill.
We decided to do a little digging on that, and here's what we found out today. Time Warner offers their cheapest internet for $15 a month, Comcast offering their service for a little less, $10 a month. Going up a little, Time Warner offers television and internet for $65 a month, Comcast offering similar services for $70 a month. And to get phone service added, Time Warner offers a plan for $80 a month, plus taxes and fees. Comcast costs about $100 a month. With Google Fiber expanding to Austin, it could change the way you get television and internet. Comcast already offers service in two cities. Google already serves Kansas City and Provo, Utah. But Comcast may not be on board with what Google offers. Comcast's executive vice president does not seem to like gigabit speed internet in homes. In an editorial in a Philadelphia newspaper, he said, in part, the issue with such speed is really more about demand than supply. Most websites can't deliver content as fast as current networks move. And most U.S. homes have routers that can't support the speed already available to the home.